Hamden shukur is always to be Almighty Allah. And this complete peace and salutations be upon our only lovable our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his family and his holy family and those who follow his guidance in the day of judgment. Ameen. First of all, I convey my earthly salutations. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Allah allows 7 types of people in the world. In that, first four categories of people. And Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in one hadith, وجبت محبتي للمتحادين في والمتجادسين في والمتجاودين في والمتبادلين في. In the first category of people, Allah said, Allah made wajib upon himself that he will love everyone that loves another for the sake of Allah. Let me ask you this question: how many people can truly love him or her for the sake of Allah? Because An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, look what he said about the categories of the people. He said, on the day of resurrection, so there are people who are so close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Anbiyas, and the Nabis, and the Shaheeds, what did they do? Did you mean, what is Nabis and the Shaheeds? The Nabis is someone who is guided by Allah, and the Shaheed is someone who is gave his soul for the sake of Allah. The Nabis and the Shaheeds, they said to themselves, what did they do? What did they do to deserve their status? They are so close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what did they do to deserve their status? So one of the Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, what did they do, Ya Rasulullah? The Messenger of Allah said, the people who are only love for the sake of Allah, love one another for the sake of Allah, without any black ties, without any business transactions, just for the sake of Allah. Nowadays, in the world, find only 4 or 5 people. 4 or 5 people only, they have really love them for the sake of Allah. This is the first category of the people. And then the second category of the people, وَالْمُتَجَالِسِينَ فِي. The people, those who are sit together for the sake of Allah. Not for the political reasons, not for the social events, not for the business transactions, not for everything, not for the chai-chai. But if you sit together for the sake of Allah, you know, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz radiallahu anhu, he used to say, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz radiallahu anhu, after he finished the work of the government, he used to bring right-handed individuals and he used to say, sit, let us sit and remember Allah. Let us remember Akhirah. And those are the people who are deserves the loves of Allah. And in the third category of people, وَالْمُتَجَاوِدِينَ فِي. The people who are visiting them for the sake of Allah. Not the queue from the Jamaati Tabligh. Not you, because you are Tabligh, you are visiting Muslims. Someone you say, you know, I know where the Sayyid al-Qadi lives. I don't want a business from him. I don't want a business from him. I just want to visit him for the sake of Allah. I'm visiting no other business, no other intentions, just for the sake of Allah. Do you have that? Then you are good. And then the fourth category of the people, وَالْمُتَبَادِلِينَ فِي. Give for the sake of Allah. Those who people will give for the sake of Allah. Not only money, but sometimes you just yourself give of your times. Just yourself and give of your times. This is for the sake of Allah. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, for me to help my brothers in one little things, in one small things, is more below to me than doing itikaf in my masjid. This is the fourth category of the people. And then the second part, number 5, Ibadallah. Ibadallah. Doing nawafil. If you want Allah to love you, do nawafil, as much nawafil. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the Messenger of Allah said in one hadith, hadith in ma'ruf, very famous hadith, man ala li waliyan. At the end, he said, nothing is more below to me that I ask of my servant to perform the fard. Then, and then he said, but if my servant keep performing nawafil, which means, nawafil means, one day is sadaqas, one day is salas, one day is prayers. So then Allah said, then I will love him. So if you want, pray your sunnah, if you pray your sunnah, Allah will love you. If you pray your nafil, Allah will love you. If you pray your witr, Allah will love you. If you pray your fard, Allah will love you. This is the fourth category of, fifth category of people. And then the, this is the fifth category of people. And then the sixth category of the people, number six, is for you to be always repeating Allah and going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said in the Holy Quran, Inna Allah yubbut tawabin. Allah loves those who are always repent. Not only when they sin, but always repent. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on all of us. And the last one. And the last one, number seven. The Messenger of Allah said, Ahabun nas ilallah. He said, the most of the people beloved in the sight of Allah. And found in nas. Is more beloved to me. Is more beloved to me than most. So if you want Allah to love you, don't do that. Don't discriminate. So don't say, I will only help Somalians. I will only help Pakistanis. I will only help Indians. I will only help Syrians. Don't do that. Because I am of the faith. Don't do that. Why would I cry for my own people? If you want Allah to love you, you may benefit most of them. وَأَخِي دَوَانَا الْحَمْدِ اللَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ